So I started going through verses of the Quran, simple verses with simple lessons, in order for us to be reminded, because I'm sure we've heard so many reminders from the Quran and from the teachings of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, but we should continue to hear the reminders, and it should be over and over again, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us to continue reminding, for the reminding benefits those who believe. Your prayer times are known. You've been praying for the last so many decades or years. But every prayer, Allah's instructed someone to call to remind people, hey, it's prayer time. Thought about it? If reminding was not beneficial, you would never be hearing the adhan or having a reminder to say, Hayya ala salah, come to prayer. 5 times a day, it's repeated. We would have been taught to say, hey guy, it's enough. You told me once, now that's okay. But in fact, we should enjoy the reminder. That's a Muslim. Why is it we get upset when people correct us or remind us regarding our duty with our, or towards our maker? Why do we get upset? Don't be upset. Even if you're weak, say, Jazakallah khair, I know I'm weak, inshallah, pray for me, and so on. And it's not just pray for me. I mean, you can't have a bottle in your hand and you have, for example, something else, and you're doing the worst haram, haram, haram stuff, and then someone says, but you know, intoxicants, you know, you're not supposed to really be. No, just pray for me. Allah will guide me. That's a statement of arrogance. Don't say that. Just thank them, Jazakallah khair. May Allah guide us all. And who knows, if you know, one day I was delivering a lecture in a city. Some of you might have heard this. And I spoke about jewelry for men. Gold and you know, jewelry basically for men. Mainly it was the gold. Like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the hadith says he was seated one day and he had gold in one hand and silver in the other. And he said, Inna hadhaini haramun ala dhukuri ummati. These two are haram for the males of my ummah. So if you consider yourself from the ummah, you would consider those two haram to don, to wear. And so, I was mentioning in the hadith of the benefits of quitting something for the sake of Allah or doing something for the sake of Allah. And I just happened to mention how some people wear gold chains and so on. And I said, you know what? As much as we don't judge people, but it's not wrong for us to tell someone, to say, this is permissible and this is prohibited. I'm just making the ruling clear. There was a brother seated not so far from where I was standing and speaking. And he pulled his gold chains off. He took his earrings off. He took his rings off. He made a pile and left it in front of him. Mid-speech. It's been almost 15 years. He's one of my best friends. He's one of my best friends. It's the first time in my life I had seen instant response to a word of encouragement and advice. And I was motivated because, according to me, when we correct people, they feel upset. They come back, were you attacking me, by the way? Bro, I don't even know you, man. What was I supposed to be? Do you know when I tweet, people say, do you know me? Have you been following? No, I follow myself. Subhanallah. I don't even follow you in that sense. I don't even know who you are, besides being my brother or sister in faith.